Hello students, welcome to the session. Today we are going to discuss about the self-discipline, that is the niyama. In the last class we have seen the yama, that is the social discipline or the social code of conduct or the respecting for the others. Today we are seeing about the niyama, the self-discipline. This is the second component of the Ashtanga Yoga, the rule of self-discipline. So yama are the moral prohibitive, where the niyamas are discipline and constructive. So it tells that yama is moral, it's a prohibitive, okay, but when it comes to the niyama are very disciplined and it's constructive, which helps yourself. Yama provides the ethical foundation, and niyama will try to provide the physical, mental foundation for the further studies of the yoga. So yama can be practiced only within the society, but niyamas can be practiced anywhere irrespective of the society. And yamas are respective, niyamas are the prospective. Okay, so the shloka for the niyamas are saucha santosha tapaswadiya ishwar pranidanani niyamaha. Saucha means inner and outer purity and cleanliness. Santosha means contentment. Tapa means austerity. Swadhyaya means self-knowledge, yourself, that is the pranidanana. Ishwara means the personal God. Pranidanani means the devotion. Niyamaha means the rule of conduct or the self code of conduct. Saucha, the first part of the niyama is the saucha. So saucha swanga jigupsa parari samagraha. Saucha means purity, purification. Swa means their own. Anga means body. Swanga means one's own body. Jigupsa means distanced. Parahi means with others. Asamsagraha means the cessation of contact. Purity results in the abandonment of the physicality and the cessation of physical contact with the external things. It tells that so your purity should not be just external. Okay, purity should be internal also. Antaranga Shuddhi and Bahiranga Shuddhi plays the main role here for this saucha, that is the cleanliness. Cleanliness of a body and mind develop the disinterest in the contact with the others for the gratification. Sattva Shuddhi Samanvayasa Ekhagra Indriyatvam Atma Darshana Yogatvani Cha. Sattva means the truth, purity, light, clarity. Shuddhi means purification. Samanyasa means the higher mindedness. Ekhagra means intense. Indriya means sense. Jaya means victory. Atma means absolute. Abhimata means the absolute. Darshana means the realization. Atma Darshana means the self-realization. Yogatvani means suitability. Cha means also. Also the capacity for the clarity, cleanliness and cheerfulness and the intenseness, as well as the mastery over the sense, ultimately give rise to the self-realization. If a person wants to become a self-realization, he should be having his clarity over his thinking thoughts and also from the outer. And he should be more cheerfulness, and he should have an intense, and when he is having these things, these qualities, he can become the mastery over the senses, and he will be able to ultimately give rise to the self-realization. Santosha, that is called as contentment. So people should have the happiness from the core of the heart. So usually what happens nowadays, the santosha means the happiness from the core of the heart is not there. So santosha anuttamas sukalabaha. Santosha means contentment. Anuttama means the extreme or the supreme. Sukha means the happiness, labaha means the attained or the satisfaction. So the conclusion tells about the santosha is an attitude of contentment give rise to the unexcelled happiness, mental comfort and joy and satisfaction. Here it tells that if a person wants to get a happiness from the core of his heart, he should have the attitude to feel the mental comfort, joy and satisfaction from his whatever he is doing. Swadhyaya. Swadhyaya means the self-study. So self-study means it is being telling that like you should have the acquiring of knowledge by both theoretically and practically when you are doing more effort by studying by yourself. So the Patanjali explained in the following ways: Dirgha Kala, that is the studying should be there for a longer period; Nirmayantara, that is it should nirantara, okay, it should be continuous without any uninterruptedness; and also the Satakarvisetto, that is it tells that it should have the unconditional faith. The style of studying will depend on the individual self. So everyone will be having the gaining of knowledge in the different views, but without depending on others, if you are practicing by yourself, then you can gain the knowledge to the peak level. Okay, Swadeya Ishta Devata Samprayogaha. So it tells that Swadeya means the self-study or the learning from oneself. Okay, Ishta means loved, sought out. Okay, Devata means godliness, Samprayogaha means connect with or oneness. So the conclusion of the Swadeya tells that self-study and reflection on yourself brings you into the contact with the desire ideal. So it tells that if you are without depending on anyone, if you are doing by yourself, so that will be having a lot of reflection on the things whatever you are doing, and it will try to contact with your desire ideal. So you will be following, so you will be having a desired ideal by yourself, so you will be able to understand about yourself. And if you are without depending on anybody, so if you are doing by yourself, then you can gain the self-study and you can be more confident on yourself. So thank you students for your patient listening. So today we have been completed the niyama. In niyama we have been completed the saucha, santosha and swadhyaya. So in the next session we'll be seeing the tapas and ishvara pranidhana. Thank you.